Now let us discuss armature reaction. This is also creating problem in commutation as discussed in our previous cases. So first we will try to understand what is armature reaction, and then we will discuss how it is going to affect commutation, how it is going to create problem in commutation. This figure shows the field setup: north pole, south pole, two pole DC machine is there. Still, we are not rotating the rotor, hence no EMF is induced in the rotor conductors, armature conductors. Only field windings are excited, hence the field fluxes are shown. Now, let us, the rotor is being rotated in clockwise. Now, we are going to rotate in clockwise. We can rotate in anti-clockwise or clockwise. Let us take the clockwise direction. So when rotor will start rotating, the armature conductors will also start rotating in the same direction at same speed, and hence EMF will induce in the armature conductors. We have discussed it in our previous lectures. Now, as soon as load is connected across the output terminals of DC generator, load current will start flowing in armature conductors. These armature conductors having armature current will have associated magnetic field as shown in figure. So we know how to get the direction of current in the armature conductors. Now this rotor is rotating in clockwise direction. So you at any point of time, at any position, we can take V like this. Suppose we are taking this tangential and B. Here also B will be perpendicular. So let us take the direction V cross B into the plane. So cross here. For example, if we want here, so direction is this way. So here direction is this. This is V and this is B. So V cross B. V cross B. This is V. So V cross V, the movement is outward, out of the plane, that's why dot will be there. So everywhere dot here and cross here. So corresponding flux direction. So this is cross, that's why the flux will be like this. Take in right hand, right? Curling of the finger will give you this. Similarly, at this point, current is this way. So take this and this will be the direction of flux lines. So now we have two fluxes, one flux shown in the air gap, main field flux produced by the field windings, and the other flux is armature flux produced by the armature currents as shown in the figure. We can observe that in the upper portion of pole faces, pole face of north pole, the net flux is more than the individual one, because it adds, the armature flux adds the with the field flux. On the other hand, on this side of pole face, see the two directions are opposite. This is main field flux and this is armature flux. So the net effect will be reduction in the total flux. Similarly, here also, in the upper portion of this pole face, we can see that armature flux opposes the main field flux, whereas in the lower portion of pole face, the two fluxes help each other. This is armature flux direction and this is main field flux direction. That's why the flux density will be more here and lesser here and here. So the resultant is shown here like that. This is known as geometrical neutral axis, geometrical GNA, right? And we have already discussed what is MNA. We have north pole region, we have south pole region. So in between a pair of pole, one line, one axis is there, that is known as magnetic neutral axis. That is basically a boundary between the two regions, north pole region and south pole region. We have discussed that also. So here GNA and MNA, magnetic neutral axis, will coincide. So if the conductors are being rotated in clockwise direction, so you can observe that the conductors corresponding to this MNA, magnetic neutral axis, or GNA, geometric neutral axis, the EMF induced is zero as long as load is not connected. EMF can be induced without connecting load, yes. So as long as load is not connected across the output terminals of this generator, DC generator, the EMF induced in these conductors are as shown, and the polarity of EMF induced in these conductors are as shown, but no EMF will induce in these two conductors lying along the magnetic neutral axis, right? Now, as soon as load is connected, so we can see that the armature flux distorts the main field flux like this. So this time the MNA has shifted. You can see the density, this side the density is more an upper face, pole face, upper side of pole face, and flux density is more in lower side of pole face and lesser in upper side here and lesser here. So basically it shifts this magnetic neutral axis in the direction of rotation for this generator. So if we are going to draw a phasor diagram, so this is our main field flux in this direction, and this is armature flux, see downward direction, we can see direction downward, and this is current direction, thumb is in the current direction here, 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 so downward, downward, here, downward, downward, so net flux, armature flux is downward. So the resultant of these two will be like this, and earlier the GNA or MNA at no load was perpendicular to this line phi f, now the phi has been changed to phi r, resultant of the two fluxes, main field flux and armature flux. So this time the MNA on load will be like this, magnetic neutral axis. If we are going to increase the load further or decrease the load further, if you are going to decrease the load, so let us say this will be phi r dash, so we may see that this will be phi ar, armature flux, if we are going to decrease load, so armature flux will decrease, so phi r will also shift up, so MNA will shift up, new MNA, MNA dash, shift up, and vice versa. If we are going to increase this phi AR armature flux, so we may see that the resultant will be in this direction and MNA will shift in the direction of rotation. Let us say this MNA double dash. So you may observe that the shift in MNA basically depends on the loading of generator. So finally, we can conclude that this armature reaction creates two serious issues, two serious problems. One is it shifts the MNA, magnetic neutral axis. How it is going to affect, we will discuss later. And second is it reduces the main field flux. Main field flux here, whatever the main field fluxes are there, it reduces the net flux. How? We will discuss it later. So first discuss the first problem, which is it shifts the magnetic neutral axis. So for generator, the magnetic neutral axis is shifted in the direction of rotation, whereas in case of DC motor, in DC motor, the direction of current will be reverse of that. In generator, we are feeding to the supply, and in motor, we are taking from the supply. So current direction in the armature current will be opposite to this. Hence, the armature flux directions will be opposite to this. So in that case, the fluxes will bunch up more on the tip of pole faces opposite to that shown here. So in case of motor, the densities will be more here and less here, and more here, less here, right? So in that case, in case of motor, the magnetic neutral axis will shift in opposite direction, that is opposite to the direction of rotation of the rotor in case of motor. By anyhow, what is big deal with this change in magnetic neutral axis? Remember, when brushes are placed along DNA, here the mRNA coincides DNA, so as long as generator is not loaded, there will not be any problem, because the commutator segment shorted by the brushes will not have any EMF induced across them. The two segments, remember, whenever a brush is going to short a two segment, the coil ends connected between these two segments, with these two segments, are not going to induce any EMF, hence no problem, as no voltage drop is there, because along magnetic neutral axis, EMF induced in the windings will be zero, coils will be zero. As soon as alternator is loaded, then magnetic neutral axis will be shifted. The magnetic neutral axis will be shifted, and that shifting creates problem in the form of a sparking between the commutator segment shorted by the brush placed along the this axis GNA, that is old MNA, that is MNA at no load. So we know that MNA depends on load. When load is not there, that will coincide with GNA, geometrical neutral axis. Whenever you are going to load your generator, DC generator, it will shift depending upon the amount of load. So once the MNA is shifted, an MNA, a conductor along MNA will not induce any EMF, but the commutator segment shorted by brushes placed along the MNA on low load will now have certain finite value of EMF induced across them. This will create circulating current between the shorted segments shorted by the brush, and large spark will occur on brushes when a brush is trying to leave a particular segment. We know that segments are rotating. So once a brush touches two segments having finite value of EMFs, hence circulating current will flow between the segments. And whenever that circulating current is being interrupted, the moment when the brush is about to leave that segment, a spark will happen, large spark will happen. So this creates problem. Now come to the second problem caused by the armature reaction, that is reduction in main field flux. Generally, all machines operate near to the saturation point. So when the fluxes add together, these two fluxes are having same direction. So in the upper portion of pole face, we can see that armature MMF helps the main field MMF. So corresponding to these two, the increase in flux is less because of the saturation, whereas on the lower portion of this pole face, the two MMFs oppose each other. Armature MMF corresponding to this opposes the main field MMF. So this decrease in net MMF is larger as compared to increase in this portion, and vice versa here also. The net increase in flux due to addition of two fluxes is lesser than the net decrease in the resultant flux due to subtraction of two fluxes, armature flux and main field flux. So main field flux minus armature flux, this is decreased more than this has been increased in this portion. How? In detail we are going to discuss here. Let us plot the curve between MMF, represent it by this MMF, and flux. So the curve is linear initially, then it starts saturating. So as discussed, most of the machines operate near its saturation point. So let us take this point. The unit is ampere turn. You may write ampere turn, and this unit is unit of phi is in Weber, right here Weber. So this is the main field MMF right here, field MMF, and this is field MMF plus armature MMF. So corresponding to this location, this location where two MMFs help each other, we can observe that the increase in del phi, we will write here INC, this is increase in del phi, is this. With the same amount of subtraction in MMF, let us mark this and write this as field MMF minus armature MMF. The two MMFs oppose in this region. So the extent of addition and opposition is same, as flux lines are same, close paths. But the net effect on flux is like this. In the field MMF, when armature MMF is added, so the net effect is increase in phi flux per pole. When the armature MMF opposes the main field MMF, the net effect is field MMF minus armature MMF, the same amount. But here the decrease, this del phi DEC, we can observe that the decrease is more than the increase in main field flux. Because this curve is not linear, because of this saturation, so the net effect is the net reduction in the main field flux, average value of main field flux under a particular pole face, similarly for the other pole face. So the average value of flux per pole is reduced. So what is big deal with this? If phi is reduced, remember EMF equation. In EMF equation, we saw that E is K phi N. or this implies k phi n. So let us take first the case of generator. When phi is decreased, n is maintained constant, speed of turbine prime mover. So with decreased value of phi, E will be decreased. Okay, E will be decreased in case of generator. What about motor? So in motor, in generator we are going to induce EMF, that is output, but in motor E is our input, basically V terminal voltage, and V is nearly equal to E in case of motor. We will discuss later when we are going to study motor. So this, and this is equal to K phi n. So here supply voltage is constant, similarly this is also constant. So with decrease value of this, we will see that phi is proportional to E upon n for DC machine. And if this is maintained constant, as supply voltage across the terminal, supply terminals are constant, then with decreasing a phi, n will increase. That is, if phi decreases, n of motor increases. When n increases, load increases. Load increases. It draws more load current. When load current will be more than the previous one, then this armature MMF will be more than the previous one. Then further phi will be decreased. Then further n will be increased, and this so on, so on. So this will be repeated, and some shunt motor may reach to run away speed if proper connection is not maintained to disconnect the machine from the line, from the main line, otherwise it will destroy itself. So this is the harmful effect of decreasing net flux with increasing armature current in case of motor. Now let us make a cut from here. Let us cut from here and take the south pole here and north pole here. Make a cut here from here and take the straight view like this. So this rotational direction we have taken as clockwise. So for generator, this is the direction of rotation of these conductors. So for this case, these conductors are shown here, dot dot dot. These two conductors are lying along the GNA, no EMF induced when the alternator is not loaded. We are just showing the polarity. So we are going to analyze the two MMF waves together, and their resultant will be plotted to analyze the net reduction in main field flux, as well as how the MNA is being shifted in the direction of rotation for generator and opposite to that for a DC motor. So first draw, take axis along this. And mark this point. This is magnetic neutral axis, and plot the waves this we have plotted. Field MMF, right here, field MMF. Field MMF, here take MMF as ampere turn. Here take time. So this is taken as positive direction, entering into this south pole. So this is positive, and this will be negative. So this positive half of the main field MMF is this, and corresponding to North Pole, this is negative of that. This is now come to the armature MMF. So armature MMF, if this is positive direction, then this one will be negative. So upper half is having opposite direction than the lower half of this pole face for armature fluxes. We can see in lower half armature fluxes are entering, means along the direction of this, but in upper half opposite to this. So for South Pole region, the armature MMF will be plotted like this. Let us start from here, take mid, and this is the like this. Then after that, in north pole region, we may see that this upper half is along the direction of this and lower half is opposite to that of this, right? So means if this is negative, then opposite will be positive. So write this as armature MMF. And just we have drawn the plot between flux and MMF. So linearly, they are linearly related unless saturated, right? So we can plot the combined resultant flux. Let us take phi as Weber and add these two. Let us take the combined effect. So this will be somewhat like somewhat mark this point, then again the same nature will be repeated and it will go like that, and then mark this point like this. So make one more corresponding to saturation right here. Unsaturated. So due to saturation, this much amount has been decreased. Reduced flux, write down. Reduction due to saturation. Now one more thing you can observe. This is original magnetic neutral axis, this point at no load, MNA at no load, old MNA or GNA you may write, MNA at no load, that is GNA. Geometric neutral axis, this one, but this one is the new MNA at load. At load. So as load increases, this shift also increases. So this will increase, as well as the net reduction in phi will be more, right? So as discussed, for some DC shunt motor, when phi is decreased, so speed increases, that further increases the load current, and then further increases the effect of armature reaction, that is armature current will be increased, then armature flux will be increased, then its effect, so its effect on the main field flux will increase, that is armature reaction, right? So and so on. So continuous decrease in phi may result in runaway condition for the DC shunt motor. If this is not disconnected from the power line, then it may destroy itself. So this was the two harmful effect of armature reaction. So if someone asks what is armature reaction, in single line you can say that armature reaction is effect of armature flux on main field flux. How it is going to affect? So it is going to affect two ways. One way is it shifts the direction of MNA in the direction of rotation for generator and opposite to the direction of rotation for motor, DC motor, right? So the other effect is net reduction in the main field flux, how we have seen with the help of that curve, that net contribution in addition of armature MMF helps in increase in phi, net phi, with lesser amount than the net decrease due to opposition of armature MMF to the main field MMF, which results in reduction in the net phi more than the increment in the net phi, right? So resultant is net resultant flux is reduced from the original one. That is the average value of net flux throughout a pole phase is reduced from the previous one, and that's why this harmful effect is there associated with this armature reaction. Thank you very much.